Hi everyone and good evening once again. Today there has been an RSS twist to the ongoing Sandeshkhali saga. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, in as many words, has called the Sandeshkhali scandal one that has been orchestrated by the RSS. She says the women who are claiming they have been raped by TMC men have been planted by the RSS. She's also defending the TMC man at the heart of the scandal, Sheikh Shah Jahan, saying he's being framed and hounded. She goes on to make a grave charge against the BJP and the RSS, saying they are planning to orchestrate riots in the area.
আপনারা জানেন জীবনে আমি কোনো অন্যায়কে কোনোদিন প্রশ্রয় দিইনি এবং আমি ইনিশিয়েটিভ নিয়ে স্টেট কমিশন পাঠিয়েছি আমাদের অ্যাডমিনিস্ট্রেশন পাঠিয়েছি 17 জনকে অ্যারেস্ট করা হয়েছে এবং আপনারা দেখেছেন যারা মুখে মাস্ক পরে পরে ছবি তুলছে ধরাও পড়েছে বিজেপির কর্মী কিভাবে তারা বাইরে থেকে নিয়ে এসে একটা এলাকাকে অশান্ত করার চেষ্টা করেছে আগে টার্গেট শেখ সাজান ওকে টার্গেট করে ইডি ঢুকলো সন্দেশখালি আজকে নতুন না ওখানে আরএসএস এর একটা ভাষা আছে
ক্যা কাহা উনহোনে সন্দেশখালি ইজ আ বার্নার অফ আরএসএস What do you mean by this, Mamataji? Why you have become so ugly, so cruel, so anti-woman, Mamataji? TMC ke gurge mahilaon ko raat mein knock karte hain. Unka yon shoshan karne ka prayas karte hain. Wo khulkar bol rahi hain. Rajpal ji ke samne gayi aur aap Vidhan Sabha mein bolti hain ki RSS ka burner hai. Shame on you, Mamataji.
As Mamata Banerjee defends Shah Jahan Sheikh in Calcutta, on the borders of Sandeshkhali, drama continued today as well. BJP's Suvendu Adhikari tried reaching Sandeshkhali and, as expected, was blocked. Mr. Adhikari alleges that he was not just stopped but kicked by a police officer as well. He is now threatening to move court against the Bengal administration, stopping the BJP from entering Sandeshkhali, despite the court saying there is absolutely no need for prohibitory orders there.
अरे भाई बूट से पीटा बूट का से मेरा पाह में पहले बढ़ रहा था मुझे पाह में बूट से ए मियार डीएसपी फोर्थ टाइम एमएलए एक्स मिनिस्टर लीडर ऑफ अपोजिशन टू टाइम एमपी थ्री टाइम काउंसिलर व्हाट टाइप ऑफ बिहेवियर
Now, the showdown is unfolding not just in Sandeshkhali, but in other parts of the state as well. BJP leaders have hit the streets in Shiluguri and Purba Bardhaman districts. In Purba Bardhaman, they burned tires to demonstrate against the state administration. Then there was high drama in Siliguri as well. It's on your screens. BJP workers getting into a scuffle with the police there. Even the CPM staged a protest against the Mamata Banerjee government in Bashirhat. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's turn our focus on the allegations at the heart of the Sandeshkhali scandal. Some women there have alleged that they were raped over many, many years by TMC men inside the TMC office. The BJP says it was only Hindu women who were targeted. The police, on the other hand, says they have spoken to many of these women who have made these allegations on camera, but they've all refused to file a complaint of rape with the police. The question is why? The governor of the state who has met these women say it's because there is a fierce psychosis that grips the area. The women, who have been called masked BJP agents, have spoken to the Times Network, and we have absolutely no reason not to believe them.
এটা অনেক রাতে রাত্রে রাত্রে যে মেম্বারদেরকে মিটিংয়ে ডাকতো বলে দিত যে বাড়িতে এসে 100 লোক 150 লোক করে সেখানে নিয়ে গিয়ে হাজির করতে হবে যারা যারা নিয়ে যাচ্ছে না তাদেরকে পাঠিয়ে দিচ্ছে বাড়িতে গিয়ে 150 করে লোক নিয়ে এসো তাদের গলে তাদেরকে বলছে না এক্ষুনি চলে যেতে হবে সেই সুদূর আমরা স্বামী ছেলে পুড়ে সংসার ছেড়ে সেখানে রাত 10টা 11টার সময় পর্যন্ত সেখানে থাকতে হচ্ছে
কিন্তু এই রাতের ডাকার বিষয়টা কি মানে মহিলাদের
বিষয়টা কি সেটা তো আমরা তো জানি না আমাদেরকে এসে হুমকি দেখাবে না তোমাদেরকে এখন যেতেই হবে
আমরা রাস্তায় চলতে পারি না যে মহিলার যে রাস্তায় চলবে তা সে চলার যে ইয়ে নেই রাস্তায় বেরোলি হ্যাঁ তুলে নিয়ে যাবে, তাহলে এরকম করলি তাহলে আমরা কি করে বাঁচবো? তাহলে আমরা মহিলা হ্যাঁ বাচ্চা কাচ্চা নিয়ে হ্যাঁ
কি কি হতো, মানে কাদের ওরা বেছে নিত আর কেন?
মানে প্রত্যেককে গ্রামের প্রতিটা মা বোনদেরকে ওরা ডাকতো জোর করে যে তোমাদের যেতে হবে তো যেতে হবে এক্ষুনি, এরকম যে তোমরা বারণ করবে সেটা বারণ করার কিছু মানে বারণ করলে শুনবে না তো, জোর জবরদস্তি আরো জোর জবরদস্তি করবে যে তোমরা এদিকে মানে আসতেই হবে তোমাদেরকে, আমাদের মানে এমন এখন পরিস্থিতি যে মানে মানে যেতেই হবে, আমরা যদি আমাদের ইচ্ছা অনিচ্ছা কোনো কিছু ব্যাপার নেই, এখানে ওরা যেটা বলবে যেটা করবে সেটাই মানে সঠিক।
আর না গেলে কি আপনাদের উপরে কোনো
হামলা? আমাদের উপরে বিভিন্ন ভাবে অত্যাচার হতো, কিন্তু আমাদের থেকে আমাদের বাড়ির লোকেদের কাছে প্রচুর চাপ আসতো যে পাঠাবে তোমার বউকে পাঠাতেই হবে এরকম।
This is an election year, so the BJP is mounting pressure on the TMC. West Bengal's BJP has shared this video of TMC's Lok Sabha MP from Bashirhat. This is Nusrat Jahan celebrating everything from Valentine's Day to Rose Day, completely unmindful and unaware of the women in her own constituency who are making grave allegations of rape against the party that Nusrat belongs to. The BJP wanted to ask and did ask, where is Nusrat Jahan's sense of priority? Is Valentine's Day and Rose Day more important than the women of her constituency?
And Nusrat Jahan, the MP of Sandeshkhali, Bashirhat, where is she? She is busy shooting for Valentine's. What a shame! When mothers and sisters are getting raped, molested day after day, Nusrat Jahan, you being the MP of Bashirhat, you are busy having a good time with your husband in Valentine's Day. What candidate have you selected, Madam Mamata Banerjee? We are ashamed.
Now, amidst the controversy over Sandeshkhali, TMC MP from Jadavpur, Mimi Chakrabarty, also an actor, has announced her resignation, expressing unhappiness over the party leadership. Now, as per sources, Mimi in her letter to Mamata Banerjee has said that she has been harassed and insulted on various occasions, prompting her to take this step. Mimi recently had resigned from the membership of two standing committees of parliament. She had also resigned from the post of chairperson of two hospital management committees recently. So perhaps the move was already coming. My guest this evening, Keya Ghosh, is spokesperson of the BJP. Karan Varma is an author. Dr. Riju Datta is spokesperson of the TMC. And Tausif Ahmed Khan is a political analyst. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. Dr. Riju Datta, I'm going to start with you and ask you and your party to make up your mind. 2 days ago, on this very show, the TMC representative was blaming the left front. And he told me on this show, and that's an honorable member of parliament, Dr. Sen, comes to the show and tells me that it is the left that is creating all the trouble in Sandeshkhali. It's the left who has paid these women 5,000 rupees each to speak lies against the TMC and its men just to get the TMC into trouble. Now, today, Mamata Banerjee is saying it's the doing of the RSS. So, Dr. Riju, the TMC has to make up its mind. Is it a TMC sazish? Is it a RSS sazish? Or is it a left sazish? If it is a sazish at all, which I dispute, but anyhow,
let me be very blunt. There is not one single complaint of rape or sexual torture to any women. Let me get it straight on the record. Now, what is happening on the other side? First, yes, it was CPM, the ex-MLA Nirapod Shardar, who's been arrested by Bengal police. And the BJP leader Vikas Singh, who's the observer of the area, has also been arrested. It's a cohorts of the BJP and the CPM that is doing this. And why I say this is because these women that are coming in front of the media, hiding their faces and explaining all this, now, these so-called perpetrators are not in the picture. Sheikh Shahjahan is absconding. One is behind bars. Another one is still not, there is no complaint against him. Now, why now these women are not filing a complaint? Why they have not filed a written complaint with the governor himself? But on the other flip side,
Agni Mitra Paul, BJP MLA,
her call recording has been exposed. Can I finish, please, Shreya? Agnimitra Paul, a BJP MLA, her call record has been exposed, where she's telling a journalist, we are going there to create a riot-like situation like Singur and Nandigram. Another thing, Sukanta Mojumdar, the state BJP president, again the video has come out in the open, where he's been pulled down by his own security, falls on the bonnet of his car, gets admitted himself into ICU, and says Trinamool is hitting him. And Suvendu Adhikari, because he's in a competition with Sukanto, who can play the victim card more, is saying that he has been booted by a police officer. What nonsense is going on? These are absolute ghost stories. Tomorrow, Keya ji is here on your show. I respect her. I know her personally. Now, if tomorrow Keya ji says, okay, Riju Datta has gone and sexually harassed a BJP karyakarta, woman karyakarta, or has done something nasty, you have to file a complaint. You have to produce those evidences in the court of law. There, all this drama is happening, but there is no written evidence, no evidence.
Okay, so Dr. Riju Datta, I take your second point, and I'll put that question to Keya, who is joining us on the show as well. But what you are telling me is that two sworn enemies, the right and the left, have actually come together in Sandeshkhali to plot the downfall of Mamata Banerjee. Is that what you're telling me?
What I am saying, Shreya, is that Amit Malviya is peddling his fountain of lies left, right and center. And during the panchayat elections, you have a fantastic library, Shreya. You can see Shubhendu Adhikari, the loser of opposition of Bengal, going from one stage to the other stage, saying, CPM, come together with us. We will fight together to beat Trinamool Congress. It's an open secret in Bengal. They're all in cahoots, CPM, Congress and BJP together against Trinamool. But it's not going to help anybody because this face narrative is coming to an end now.
Okay, Keya Ghosh, then respond to something that Dr. Rajuju is saying. And what he's saying is fairly logical. He's saying that there are these women. They have spoken to networks across India, including Times Network. They have made grave allegations of rape. The police is saying, we have formed a committee. There is a woman SP who has gone on the ground. She has tried to convince these women who have made these allegations on camera to come to the police station and file an FIR as well of rape. Now, this woman SP, after her efforts, is saying that four women did come forward, but none of them have filed a complaint of rape. So how do we believe that there has been rape in Sandeshkhali if the women themselves don't want to file it? They are okay to say it to the governor. They are okay to say it to the on camera, to television networks. But why not then come to the police station and file a complaint of rape?
See, Shreya, firstly, it's a matter of shame that the serial rapists, the serial person who had created terror in this area, the ruling party, including the CM herself, is shielding this Sheikh Shahjahan and his bandwagon members. Having said that, you have asked a very important question. And through time mirror now, I would like all the viewers to know the reality. That yes, many people have personally also approached to me and said that why have not they filed an FIR? They have been, these ladies, some women, they have said on camera in vernacular media that when we went to lodge a complaint, not during this time, during this period of terror, when they used to be called for, you know, manoranjan ke liye unko bulaya jata tha, they went to the police station. The Boro Babu, the OC of the police station, said, you go to Shahjahan or it's his people and you talk to them, sort it out. So just imagine the person who's the perpetrator himself, the rapist himself. The police is sending these women to the rapists. And now I want to tell you the second part. Day for yesterday, one of the minister of Trinamool, he went to Sandeshkhali and said, Khala hobby. What sort of shameless thing is this? Women, thousands of women, they are coming out on street, on camera. They're facing the camera and said, yes, humare saath aisa hua hai. Things or such things have happened with us. And now they are saying khala hobe. And this is the kind of indulgence TMC is giving to these and shielding this Sheikh Shahjahan and their goons. I am telling you on camera with full responsibility. I'm telling you on camera with full responsibility, uh-huh. Shreya, that you have no idea till at this moment while I'm talking to you, these women, they're all by themselves in the village because all their husbands, if they were there, they would have been given false cases. They would have been put under behind bars. And these ladies, they are protecting themselves with the help of conch. They are blowing the conch shells. They are keeping a vigil for themselves, looking out for any outsiders who
Dr. Riju
are coming
Datta?
Inside the village to further
Keya,
terrorize them.
Keya,
so this is the thing.
Keya Ghosh, yes, there is more media in Sandeshkhali than the police. So I doubt that, as you know, I understand the fear psychosis, but with so much media being around there, I don't think that's entirely the case. But anyhow, Dr. Riju, what do you want to say?
No, this is the case.
Because I want to go to the other panelists as well. Go ahead.
5 seconds more. Shreya, 5 seconds more.
Give me a minute.
Please. 5 seconds. Riju, please, 5 seconds.
Acha, let Keya speak.
The Honorable Governor, when he went to meet these victims, those two main complainants, they were not allowed to meet. They were confided, they were forced to stay within the village, their village. And they complained that we were not allowed to meet the Honorable Governor. Such is the police. They are acting as Trinamool cadres. They are acting as goons. And they are practically shielding the rapists from meeting the victims from meeting the Honorable Governor or National Women's Commission delegation team.
Dr. And then Datta, TMC Keya is not the only one saying this. Okay, Dr. Datta, Keya is not the only one saying this. The governor of the state, no less, has said this and says that every police station in Sandeshkhali needs to be cleansed.
Well, Shreya, for your audience, I will say this. 17 arrests have been made. Three women came and said that Uttam Sardar used to harass us. Uttam Sardar is one of the sitting panchayat members of Trinamool Congress. Mamata Banerjee has done her Rajdharma and he is behind bars. Now, when the governor, again, I will reiterate 2 points here. Now, this is the day and age of social media. Everywhere there is cameras. These women are, why we are saying that these women are planted by the BJP is because of a very simple logic. It's a day and age of social media. Nothing can evade the cameras that are around. These women are saying on camera that we have been harassed and tortured and whatnot for the last God knows how many years. Forget Trinamool Congress. Trinamool Congress is bad. The Vikas Singh, who was arrested by Trinamool, by the West Bengal police on complaints of inciting violence, he is the observer of BJP in that area for 10 years. The CPM MX MLA, he has been in that area for the last 40 years. Why these complaints were not raised by BJP or CPM even 6 months ago? Because apparently this is going on for 10 years. Point number one. Point number two, the governor is on the ground. The commissions are on the ground. Yet the women are saying we will give bites. But every media bite that even your Times network has taken, every woman has said, nothing has happened to me personally. They used to call us to the party office. They used to ask us to cook food. But not a single woman on camera has said, I have been a victim of sexual torture or rape. That is what I am coming to. And I will pray to Mr. Governor, because the TMC delegation went to him today, that the same vigil that you went to Sandeshkhali, please go to Chopra, where BSF, due to illegal construction, has killed and murdered 4 children. That is my humble submission.
Okay. Okay, and Dr. Riju, I'll tell you one thing. I'll tell you one thing about sexual violence against women. 1 minute, Sun Lijiye.
He's sitting gladly in the parliament.
You know, I've covered enough riots in this country. I've covered enough riots in this country to tell you that women, when women talk about sexual exploitation, sexual assaults during times of crisis, especially during times of conflict, the testimonies come out the way coming out of Sandeshkhali. No woman will come out and say, I was raped. She'll always say, someone I knew has been raped. This happened to such and such person's daughter, etc., etc. They never take it on to themselves because there is a certain shame associated with it. Dr. Riju Datta, I've seen enough of it. But I do think that the TMC is raising a valid point as well. Karan Manma, come in here. Many people will listen to what the TMC is saying. Forget the political rhetoric about the RSS being involved, about, you know, the RSS trying to orchestrate a riot, etc. At the crux of the entire argument is, if there has been rape in Sandeshkhali over the last 10 years, why is it being spoken about now? And it is being spoken about. If it's being spoken about, why is it not being reported in the police? You say fear psychosis. Ab kya fear psychosis ho rakha hai? Duniya bhar ki to media is now there. The governor is there. The entire country's eyes are at Sandeshkhali. What can be the fear psychosis now for the women not to go to the police station and file a complaint of rape despite the police saying, please file it?
No, I'm very glad, Shreya, that you pointed out that what a person goes through in such a scenario, and it's so difficult for one to come up forward and say that, you know, I have been the victim of it. But let's understand this. My friend, Mr. Riju Datta, he just said that 17 have been arrested and Uttam Sardar has been acted upon. At one end, you are saying nothing was wrong. And at the other end, you are saying Mamata Banerjee discharged her Raj Dharma and arrested 17 people and took action against Uttam Sardar. So you have to make your mind as to what has happened here. And victim shaming has been a trademark of the Mamata Banerjee government. You remember what happened in the Hansakali rape case, where she said, oh, it could have been a love affair that has gone wrong. Or where in Malda, a woman was paraded naked. So these are horrific things that have happened, and Mr. Riju Datta cannot brazen it out like this, sitting in a studio or sitting in front of a camera. This cannot work like this, and this government has been guilty of it for quite some time. You remember back in 2021, the post-poll violence, when the NHRC came heavily on it, and not just the NHRC. Every time there has been a probe, whether it's by the NHRC, whether it's by the GIA, the group of intellectuals and academicians, it's the Mamata Banerjee government that has tried to scuttle the probe. It's the Calcutta High Court that has every time come heavily on the Mamata Banerjee government. Even during the panchayat violence, the violence that happened during the elections, it was the Supreme Court that came heavily on the Mamata Banerjee government. So this government has no credibility when it comes to violence, when it comes to Hindu phobia, when it comes to even brazen action against women. They have no credibility. I think they have some very serious answering to do.
Okay.
And you can't just come up with this lame argument, these are BJP people or this is RSS that's doing it. You are the one who needs to really answer and hang its head in shame. I say this with utmost conviction. This kind of horrendous things, these kind of horrendous things happening to women, it's a shame. And the Mamata Banerjee government shares this shame. They should hang their heads in shame today.
Tausif Ahmed Khan, if the TMC government has nothing to hide, if their man, Shah Jahan Sheikh, is as clean as the river Ganga, my point is, why are you not allowing the BJP leaders to come into Sandeshkhali? Why are you not allowing the scheduled caste panel that was there today to come into Sandeshkhali? They are saying presidents, that same panel is, scheduled caste panel is saying president's rule should be imposed here. They are not the BJP. The National Commission of Women is saying the same thing. Fear psychosis. The police is the one stopping these women from filing a complaint. My point is, if you have nothing to hide, let everyone go to Sandeshkhali. Calcutta High Court has already said there is absolutely no justification for any prohibitory orders. Then why have you put prohibitory orders? Why are you not letting the BJP go inside Sandeshkhali? Why are you not allowing the caste panel to go inside? Why are you not allowing the NCW to go inside? Chupa kya rahe hain aap log?
Shreya, it is a wrong notion that anybody is being stopped from going to Sandeshkhali. Only the troublemakers are being stopped. You see, all the media houses are there in Sandeshkhali from day one. Local media, Bengali regional media, or the national media. They're all there. You're reporting from there. State Commission has gone, the Women Commission has gone. You talked about SCST Commission. You see, do they have the moral ground to come and visit in Sandeshkhali when a SCST tribe person in Madhya Pradesh was stripped naked and beaten? They did not went into Madhya Pradesh and spoke to that person. And just because it helps BJP's narrative, just because they want to spread lies and misinformation. You see, and a very latest example, I will tell you, please check the Twitter of West Bengal police. Amit Malviya recently posted a video of a woman and said that this woman is being dragged by the police officer. But in fact, that woman was a complainant in one of the cases, and she was going to depose before the magistrate, and the IO, along with the four other local ladies, IO was escorting them for security purposes. But this video was posted by the BJP media cell head, and a false narration, because falsehood and lies is being used by BJP as a tool in this election. And that is what is to be, has to be called out. Mm. You see, merely, you know, I understand the law, in fact, the law is very heavily leaning in favor of women. So far, the question, so far the allegation of rape is concerned. But Shreya, you will appreciate that in order for an FIR, for the police investigation, FIR has to be lodged, a complaint has to be made. Yet, Mamata Banerjee posted a 10-member all-woman team headed by a DIG of CID, a lady officer. All 10 members, they're going door to door and meeting with the local residents in Sandeshkhali, asking them about the allegations of rape. None of them have reported rapes to these women. Secondly, the state police is making out no complaint to rape, of rape or sexual torture to them. So, you know, just simply say, coming on the camera with a covered face, and then after following that, BJP leaders coming on camera and just abusing Bengal administration.
Minute here, because there's an update in the case. Give me a minute, Tauseef, give me a minute. There's an update in the case that is just coming in. A petition has now been filed in the Supreme Court. This is breaking news that is just coming in. There's a petition now in the Supreme Court in connection with the Sandeshkhali violence. The petitioner is seeking the transfer of investigation outside West Bengal. They're saying a free and fair investigation by the CBI or the SIT being monitored by the Supreme Court is something that is required. They are also saying there should be an inquiry by a three-judge committee in line with the Manipur case. Let me go straight across to Dr. Riju, who continues to be with us. Dr. Riju, any comments to make on the news that is just coming in? Essentially, the petitioner whose identity I'm not aware of right now, and I'll just ask my producers who exactly this person is, but the petitioner is comparing what has happened in Manipur to what is happening in Sandeshkhali and saying you need to transfer this investigation outside West Bengal and give it to the CBI.
See, Shreya, I don't need to know the identity of the petitioner because the words that you have just used, what was used in the PIL, it clearly says that it's a BJP person. And, you know, everybody has their democratic right to file a PIL, and he has done that. And I believe the Supreme Court, in all its wisdom, will do the needful if they put a, if they make an SIT, more than welcome. If they disregard and quash this PIL, good enough. It is up to the Supreme Court in their wisdom to do what is needed. But Manipur is a different issue. It's still burning. People are still getting killed. And I heard a BJP person saying people of Bengal and TMC should hang their head in shame. It's a bit rich coming from these kind of people because then they should not only hang their head in shame, they should hang themselves and do us a favor. Brijbhushan Singh is still sitting in the parliament, hunky-dory, whereas the Olympians have been molested day and day and night by the BJP sitting MP. Today, the Rajya Sabha, the guy who demolished the Babri Masjid, who is the result, who has caused at least 10,000, more than 10,000 innocent people who have lost their life, has been sent to the Rajya Sabha by the BJP. BJP is giving us lectures. Where were these people? Well, okay. When Manipur happened, women are paraded naked. When Bilkis Banu's rapists were garlanded and brought by sweets, what happens to them?
You sent a civi member to Rajya Sabha.
It does not, it does not happen like
against
that.
India, the, and you're talking the, big. The world, you're talking the about, world you're talking is watching. About, Maharashtra. You're talking
at
about
the end
Manipur.
Of the day, come you need Bengal. Evidence.
Okay, you know what? I'll end this discussion here. I'll end this discussion here. Ladies and gentlemen, it's 10:30. I have to end this discussion here. Just a minute. I'll end this discussion here by saying two things. First, there is no reason for us to disbelieve these women. Yes, many people watching the broadcast will want to know the answer to the question that the TMC is raising. If these women have been raped and they're willing to give their testimonies on camera, why are they not willing to come to a police station to file an FIR? Could it be because it is out of fear? Is it something else we don't know?
Yes, of course. But,
yeah, you're saying the police did not file? The West Bengal government said the police went to these women asking them to file the complaints and they did. Again, I'm saying...
He's lying.
Take it.
The lady is lying. How shameless
no,
of you,
know,
Riju.
They have lost
this political debate and Tutu Meme will go on. But ladies and gentlemen, what we definitely need is to get to the heart of what is the truth of Sandeshkhali. We don't know it. We just know there is an allegation and we know that two political parties are fighting against each other. What is the truth? The truth will only be established after an investigation. So whether the CBI does it, whether an SIT under the mentorship of the Supreme Court does it, we don't know who will do it, but you need to know the truth of Sandeshkhali.